earthquake. Holy and most righteous God. I ask now, God, that you send your spirit that it might sanctify me. Prepare me for use in your kingdom. Your people have come tonight, Lord. Speak to their hearts. Speak to their mind. Bring them peace. Bring them joy because of your word. We thank you now. In Jesus' name. Amen. First of all, I want to say thank you for allowing me to come back again. Those of you who were here last time know I kind of lost track of time. I blame it on Rick. We went over just a little bit. So I'll try to make it up to you. I cut it short. Truly, I am grateful and very, very happy and honored to have this opportunity tonight. We will talk to you tonight, and from this is a wonderful prayer. We're going to talk about praying time. It's praying time. First, I might ask the question, what is prayer? We're going to get there, talk about it later. But right now, I would just like to read a couple of quotes that I read in a book, beginning by Andy Langford and Mark Rawls. John Calvin says, prayer is expanding our heart in the presence of God. Yeah. Prayer is expanding our heart in the presence of God. John Kennedy said, prayer is communion with God. It's a matter of making connections with the one who stands at the center of our life and joy, and to learn how to live there all the time. Sorry, Kierkegaard said, prayer does not change God, but it changes whoever prays. James Mullen, the point of prayer is not to tell God what we want, but to receive what we need. This is important to understand in our culture that caters to everyone. Prayer is not about me, it's about God. Amen. It's not about us, it's about God. I was truly moved, I guess, on Sunday when Catherine said that she would be here. It's Tuesday at 5 p.m. For 1 hour of prayer. And she asked that we could come and join her. Happy. And while I was here, the thought came to me from St. Matthew. The evening Jesus went out into the Garden of Gethsemane. And as he was preparing to go to pray, he asked for Peter, James, and John to come and go with him. He went off to pray, and he came back and he found them asleep. He said, couldn't you just pray with me 1 hour? And really, this ball of energy, because Jesus was very long, Pastor Karen, being a pastor myself, I'm sure she would like to have us come just watch with her for 1 hour. We're going to talk about praying time. Our text today is printed here, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 12 through 14. It says, "And the Lord appeared to Solomon by night and said to him, I have heard thy prayer and have chosen this place to myself, a house of sacrifice. If I shall tell him that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin and will heal the land." The setting for this text is Solomon had finished the temple of God. And now God was there to dedicate. Solomon prayed, and then a cloud filled the temple. Then Solomon had all the musicians and everybody got together and began to just praise God. Give God the glory. But Solomon, knowing how people are and what they're going through, he made a prayer to God. He asked God, he said, "Lord, if my people, when they have sinned against you, will look toward this place and pray, would you hear from heaven and answer their prayer?" So now what we have in our text is God answering Solomon. He let him know. He said, "Now, allow some things to happen to them." It's easy to think about God. God wouldn't cause these things, but as we do, we go out and we break God's law, we disobey God, and then the circumstances or the consequences of what we have done, we must suffer. If we go out and we break the law, like I have done on occasions, speeding along the highway, I broke the law. I may have had good intentions, but I still had to pay that $200-something speeding ticket. So there are things that happen in our lives. Sometimes we're praying and we are asking God for some things, but the things that we are asking for are not in God's will for us at that time, because our life is not in the right situation. And I will come in a little bit. All right, Doctor, I'm going to pray for you again. Amen. So he told me, he said, "If my people, which are called by my name," these are my people, "if they would just humble themselves and pray, if they would just realize that I am the one that they depend on." I think in the song that they were singing earlier, is here we are depending on God for everything. Sometimes we think that we got it ourselves, but when we realize that it's God that has all power, is God that is in charge of all creation, then when we pray, we realize that we're asking the Almighty God to have his way with us. Amen. Thank you, Robert. Thank you. If my my people, if you are called a Christian today, if you are a Christian today, then you are one of God's people. If you have repented of sin and accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you love Him with all your heart, then you are a child of the living God. Saying that my people will call by the Lord of themselves and for me. And that's what we talked about earlier in this thing when I read about Killinger. What he was talking about, he said his prayer is communion with God. We're talking about having that fellowship with God. We're talking about how we spend time, like be it 1 hour, 2 hours, but you spend that time just you and God. You spend that time knowing that God is present in the room with you right now. See, I don't know about you, but I brought him with me when I came. And the Spirit of God is inside each and every one of us. And that's one of the things that would, you have to come back to a Bible study to get the rest of that prayer thing. I'm going to teach you Bible study and all, so not tell you that. But anyway, the part that really get me all stirred up is when I do the Lord's Prayer. It says, "Our Father," and I stop. My Father. This is my Father. I had an earthly Father. But luckily I met Jesus along the way. And He introduced me to His Father, which is God Almighty up in heaven. Now when I say our Father, I'm talking about the Creator of this world. One who loved me just like my earthly Father. One who cared about me just like my earthly Father. But He's blessed to have more power than my earthly Father. How did I name it? Oh, Lord.
Rick, I'm going to stop because I'm getting the album.
Hallowed be thy name. Lord, I'm going to make your name holy. Lord, your name is special. Hallowed is your name. Now here I am, your child, and your spirit, your presence is on the inside of me. I must honor your name. I can't just say anything. Just was leaving a hospital or visiting someone, and The lady looked at her, my name came from Trinidad, and she said, "You a rebel?" I said, "Yes, ma'am." She said, "I want to tell you about America." I stopped, took my time to listen. She was telling me about how God had worked in the life of her family member this day. And she was giving honor and praise, and she wasn't shy about it. She said, "God did it for me." Doctor said this, she said, "But God did it." That's what we know. That's what we can really experience the presence of God. In prayer, when you take time to pray, you pray sincerely, you can experience the presence of God in prayer. Now, there's some key things to prayer. One key thing with prayer is that you must believe God is going to do what you ask him to do. All right? It's a thing called faith. You trust God. If you ask in God's will, God will answer. God will answer, I believe, all prayer. But the real problem with us in prayer is a little thing called waiting. We pray, but we don't want to take time to wait till God get ready to answer. He's God. He knows when you really need it. He'll be there. But it's hard sometimes to just wait on God, because after you wait a little, you decide you can do it yourself. I've been waiting on God to do this for me. I asked God, I asked God for this job, and I've been waiting on it. So he didn't bring it to me, and I said, "I think I'll move to California." You decide to have it. Then you get to California and you wait for 3 more months and still didn't get a job. Had you waited just 3 more days, God would have given you a job back again. It's a matter of just trusting God. And when we ask him for something, have faith and trust that he will deliver. You must pray sincerely. You must pray in faith, believing God will. And as Mother Helen said here, he says, the point of prayer is not to tell God what we want. Now, most of us, that's all we do in prayer. I just see y'all, but I'm talking about other people someplace else. But a lot of people, that's all prayer is about. They don't even pray until they get ready to tell God what they want. No time to think about just praying and telling God thanks. No time to take time out there to sit and in a most righteous cause. Have thine own way with us. Lord, speak to us individually. Reveal to us, dear God, what you would have us to do in your kingdom. Speak to us, dear God, about the love that you expect from us. Speak to us, God, help us to understand that the world knows that we are Christians not by our testimony, but by the love we demonstrate one to the other. Speak to us, Lord. God, I pray for Trinity. You had a Methodist Church of Gainesville, Lord. Be with our leaders. Be with our pastors, dear Lord. Speak to their minds. Speak to their hearts and direct them, Lord, in the path, the spiritual path, the spiritual direction that you would have them. Let us be a light, dear God, of unity. Let us be a light of righteousness. Let us be a light of holiness, dear God. Lord, I thank you. God, I thank you for who you are. I thank you for what you've done in my life on this day. And I ask you right now, God, to forgive me of whatever wrong that I have done, whatever situation I have not hollered your name, whatever thing I've done was not pleasing in your sight. God, I'm asking you to have mercy. Forgive me, dear God. I pray, dear God, for Roger today. Let your peace that pass all understanding be upon him. Help us to be content with your son, Jesus, knowing that all things will work together for good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose. Have your way with us, Lord. Help us to understand, dear God, that your Holy Spirit will pray for us. Where it said we don't even know what to ask for, but the Spirit will speak for us, God. Speak, God. Speak, Lord. Be Holy Spirit. We thank you now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.